Let's talk about that PB&J. Oh, yes. Now, I'm more of a goober guy than everybody than the rest. Remember the goober when it had the swirl of the peanut butter and the jelly in the same jar?
See, that was me. I'm a peanut butter on each side of the bread, jelly in the middle.
Oh, this was a jar that you opened it up and it kind of swirled like pepper.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
And it was peanut butter and the jelly swirled in together. That's my way of doing it, okay? But only because I'm lazy and that's less work.
I just like the extra peanut butter.
I like extra jelly. I'm a jelly person. I'm going to add some more jelly. But anyway, we never thought we'd talk about peanut butter and jelly in the show. And here we are doing it twice now.
I want a glass of milk.
I know. Chocolate milk. Joe Shane talking about PB&J like crazy and Hard Knocks. And it's funny because, you know, I was listening to another podcast and they were talking about it, the same thing we were talking about, ironically enough, about how they kept on drilling that. I'm an everyman kind of guy because I eat peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Like, and it was just came off as fake and ridiculous. And they were saying the same thing. But now we have a story that Jalen Hyatt is using PB&J. It's a giant PB&J obsession now. Apparently, peanut butter and jelly is the official meal of the New York Football Giants now. But he's doing it for a different reason. He's doing it to bulk up. Who would have thought PB&J to bulk up? Bulk up thing? Throw a little PB2 powder on top of it to get the extra calories. Like,
I'm going to take some whey peanut butter and jelly.
Yeah, like, there are other ways to bulk up without PB&J. I feel like that's not usually the one that you would do. The quote he said, though, about it, Jalen Hyatt said, "It's definitely hard for myself to gain weight." And this was on the Giants Huddle podcast, by the way. He said, "Some guys, it's easier for them to gain weight or gain muscle. For myself, it's harder. I burn a lot of calories quick. I'm just one of those guys that got to just keep eating. PB&J is one of my biggest things when you want to eat your full meal." But hold on. PB&J's was one of my biggest things because you want to eat your whole meal. So, like, is he not eating his other meals? Like, is PB&J that good he can't resist eating the whole thing?
I was about to say, like, give that man a steak and, you know, a potato. Does he not eat his whole meal? Maybe he needs a
personal chef.
Yeah.
He says, "You don't want to eat a little bit and drink a protein shake. Then you're really not getting anything. So for myself, completing your full meals and an hour later or half an hour later, that's when you put in Uncrustables or a PB&J or a little protein shake." I feel like someone needs to teach this man how to eat.
A little bit, yeah.
Like, maybe someone needs to bring this man to CeCe's Pizza for their $6.99 all-you-can-eat buffet. Like,
he's also a receiver. He doesn't want to bulk up like a lineman.
I'm not suggesting that, but it's like, I'm trying to bulk up, and I have trouble finishing my meal. Like, what? Just finish your goddamn meal. Like, are you putting too much on your plate? Are you not enjoying your food? Is there no one as good at cooking in your house? Like, do you need pre-made meals delivered to you? Like, there are programs that do these things. Like, what's going on?
If one of those programs wants to sponsor us.
I'm wondering, twogiantgoofballsmill.com. But I'm wondering, like, is he made that person who just is a finicky eater? Is that what it is? Like, is he really thinking about what he eats? Because if that's the case, if Uncrustables is your go-to, dude, you have to learn a whole new culinary world, because, oh my God, that is not that good. That is not that good. But yeah, now we think we've figured out why he doesn't want to eat, because he just doesn't know what good food is, apparently. But for the record, though, Hyatt weighed 176 pounds of last year's combine. He now says he weighs 185 pounds. So he has gained 9 pounds. You know, you don't really want to go ahead and have too much, obviously, onto him, because, like you said, you're going to start slowing him down. He's the fastest player, basically, in the NFL. You know, right up there with Tyreek Hill. If you start adding too much weight, then you're going to change that. And that's what makes him special, you know, is speed. So even the 9 pounds, you got to wonder, how much is that going to change his game? I think it'll change his game for the better, because he's that much faster that it's okay for him to lose a quarter of a step, or, you know, eighth of a step, whatever he's going to lose by that, if he has the ability to help work with press work and stuff like that a little better there. So we'll have to see. Perhaps his next step is to start putting peanut butter and jelly sandwiches into, put the Uncrustables into the protein shake for when you just go ahead and mix it up.
Just suck it all down.
That might be good. You never know. I mean, dude, they're throwing weird things in blenders. I saw this on TikTok and I tried. Okay. For those who aren't aware, I'm that person that if I find something on TikTok and it sounds gross, I'm trying it. I'm going to try it. So what they had was scrambled eggs. They turn into chocolate pudding. Yeah, right? Yeah. Yeah. So what they did, it was six scrambled eggs. It was 8 cups of cocoa powder. And eight tablespoons of cocoa powder. And then 2 tablespoons of honey. And you just blend it all together. And then you let it chill for a second so it kind of rehardens up there. I'm telling you, it actually did taste like chocolate pudding. But it tastes like unsweetened chocolate pudding without the fake sugar, if that makes sense. Like, it definitely was not as sweet as chocolate pudding would be, but it was the right color. It was the right consistency. And obviously, with all that cocoa powder, it was chocolatey. I know it sounds disgusting. It actually wasn't bad. That's the scary part.
I believe you, but I'm just in such turmoil thinking about it.
I know. I know. It's craziness. But I said it wasn't bad.
Anyway. I was going to bring up Mac from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Because when that guy decided to get fat for the show, you know what he did? He did frosted ice cream, just drank the gallon of ice cream every morning.
You could. So there's this place, and I don't think you guys have it up in Jersey.
It's a quick way to get 10,000 calories, is what he said.
You guys don't have Portillo's up there at all, do you?
I don't think so.
I've never seen one in Jersey. I could be wrong. So it's a Chicago thing, but they have them here in Florida too as well. They make a chocolate cake shake. Like, literally, they throw a big hunk of chocolate cake into the shake. You want to talk about fatten you up there? That'll fatten you
up. I just got diabetes listening to that.
Oh, my God. I'm telling you, it's spectacular. Look it up online. It's a chocolate cake shake. What's his name? Fluffy, the comedian. What's his name? Gabriel? Is it?
Enriquez or Iglesias.
Yeah. Iglesias. Yeah. Not Julio. Not Enrique Iglesias. There are other Iglesias. But yeah, he's probably a better singer than the other guys are. But but yeah, he talked about it. He was like, I go there. It's a chocolate cake shake. And he's like, it's a whole segment on it. It was hilarious. But yeah, they have them right near, you know, there's a couple of them here in the Tampa Bay area. They are amazing. Oh my God. I can't even finish it. That's how good it is. It's that feeling.
Can I have insulin listen to this?
No, it's so good. Maybe that's what Jalen Hyde needs to do to bulk up instead of these Uncrustables.
If you like that clip, then you will love the full episodes too. Find us on your favorite podcast app and look for us on all your favorite social media platforms.
Thanks so much.
Please, I'm begging you. Please, please subscribe.